خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق، أمراء المؤمنين حضرات أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجلي، وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون، اتقوا الله وأطيعوه، إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله يا رحمة للعالمين يا أبا البتول، صلاة الله عليك يا سيد الرسل يا رسول الملاحم، يا طاهر يا ماحي يا غفور يا رؤوف يا رحمة للعالمين. الصلاة والسلام عليك من الله إليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله، الصلاة والسلام عليك من ملائكة السماوات والأراضين إليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله، الصلاة والسلام عليك من صحابتك الكرام ومن أمتك الفخام الذين آمنوا بك ولم يروك، الصلاة والسلام عليك ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته ورضوانه عليك في العالمين، إنه حميد مجيد. أعلى الله تعالى درجاتكم دائما، وأمدنا بمددكم ونفعنا ببركات أنفاسكم القدسية يا من أرسله الله تعالى رحمة للعالمين. أيها المسلمون الحاضرون، اتقوا الله وأطيعوه، إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. O Muslims, believers, 2 days ago there was a full eclipse of the moon. And these are signs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent to the ummah, to the human beings, even to jinn, to angels, that I am the one, that I created this creation. And it's so technical, very technical system, very perfect system, that all you human beings, you never can do something like that. Can anyone make an eclipse on the moon, of the moon, from human beings, all their technology that they have? They can do anything about eclipse of the sun? No. Allah is giving signs. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when there is an eclipse of the moon, you have to be frightened. You have to be aware that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is great. Allah giving you signs. Don't look at the eclipse of the moon. Don't look at the eclipse of the sun. Because these are signs to make people to be aware of something big is coming. And this is full eclipse. Lot of bad energy coming. Who is this being described in the Holy Quran as the moon, as the full moon? Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdalus salatu wassalam. He is the sun, he is the moon. Means when that eclipse comes, Prophet is showing his unhappiness with his ummah. When the eclipse of the sun comes, this is a sign that Allah gave to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to say that I'm not happy. I'm happy when you are good. I'm happy when you are happy by obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and disobeying shaitan. Eclipses of the moon and the sun, don't think they are something
systematically.
Allah was able to change it, it was not necessary to make it.
But He made it because He wants His Prophet to give something to the Ummah, to be aware of. Allah was able, Allah created creation for Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, I create that creation for you.
إِنَّ الدُّنْيَا لَا تَزِرُ جَنَاحَ بَعُوضًا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. This whole dunya doesn't weigh a wing of a mosquito to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is not able to create other creation. Who knows that Allah did not create other creations? Allah created creations that we don't know. One time, Sayyida Fatima al-Zahra alayha afdal salatu wa salam wa alayha salam,
she said, I usually, my husband Sayyidina Ali, usually disappears for some days and nights from the house. And I said, might be he has something that he is doing. But this is going repeatedly going on and going on. I was not able to take it anymore. I went to my father asking, oh my father, you are the seed of messengers. You are the prophet that Allah has sent to humanity as mercy for the humanity. I'm not coming to complain. I never complain. I am your daughter. You did not complain, I'm not complaining. Prophet never complained. How much he was abused, never complained.
He never said no,
as we said 2 days ago in the evening.
He said no, he never said no. When Allah ordered something, he said yes. Sayyidina Musa, how many times said no?
Oh Allah, forgive me, I cannot go against Fir'aun.
Sayyidina Muhammad never say no. We are his ummah, we must not say no to anything.
We must accept everything. He said only one place he said no.
All his life never said no, only one place.
When he said, La ilaha illallah. He said, no God except Allah. No ilah except Allah.
There where he said no, he used it in order to negate that there is no ilah and to affirm except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
O Muslim, let us look at ourselves. How many times we say no?
Can we say no to our ego? That's the problem. We can say no to anyone other than ourselves. But can we say to ourselves, to our own desires, no, when we are committing a sin? Islam is not only 5 prayers as people are praying. It's not only the basics, the 5 pillars. Islam is the values, the moral excellence, the behavior, the character that Prophet has taught his Sahaba. Where are these teachings today? These teachings disappear today. No one speaks about them. Maqamul Ihsan. How to have relationship with ourselves, with our brothers and sisters, and with our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
No more is teaching. They teach you, go to a certain school, they say it's protocol school. How to speak with people? How to eat with your left hand? Is not? They are teaching you, you cannot eat with your right hand. They say, oh, this is awkward. These are old people. They are, when you sit on the table with protocol people, they put for you the knife and the fork on the left hand, the knife on the right hand, because Shaitan told them. Put it on the right, and let them eat on the left, with the left. And Prophet ﷺ said, whoever eats with the left, الشيطان is eating that food. You are not eating that food. He said, teach your children by tying their hands behind their backs to teach them to eat by right, not to eat by left. To eat by left. Tie it for them. So this behavior, this moral excellence that we used to see from our back home, from the, our elders, we don't see it today. Masajids today are so much politically concerned, or their opinions is only how to politically to live, not how morally to live. Sahaba were able to bring people to Islam by their behaviors, not by their teachings. They went to Central Asia, to China. They converted people back to Islam, and they didn't know the language. Only by their heart, through their heart, from that light that Prophet ﷺ put in their heart. And for sure Prophet will put in anyone's heart light if you are willing to. If you are not willing, you don't want to put electricity in the mosque, then there is no electricity, it's dark. You don't want to put a light in your heart, it will be dark. That light has to come. Don't tell me nonsense. Has to come from Prophet ﷺ. He is our intermediary. He is our intercessor. He is our means to everything. Without Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ support, Allah will not open His door to us. So she came to Prophet, go back to this story. She came to Prophet and said, "Yeah, oh my father, I'm not complaining. You are the seal of messenger, you are everything. But I'm speaking as a daughter." She said, "Say what you want to say. You don't wish to be a son of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? You don't wish to be a daughter to Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? We are begging." We are begging to be children for Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, for him to open his heart to us. We have rude hearts. We have strict hearts. We don't care for anything. We forget about him in 1 second. As soon as we go out somewhere, finish. She said to him, "Oh my father, I love you." Who doesn't love Prophet? "I love you, but I want to ask you that question." He said, "Ask." She said, "My husband, Ali, كرم الله وجهه ورضي الله عنه, is absent for some nights from the house. And this time he is a little bit more absent. But he didn't come to the house. And I know he's not anywhere. Where is he?" He said, "Ya Fatima, don't ask about Ali. He is your husband. I am sending him as my messenger. I'm sending him where no one can reach. I'm sending him where not one human is able to reach. He is Asadullah al-Ghalib. Allah described him as he is the lion, the victorious, the winner lion for the Ummah. I am sending him where no one reached and no one knows. I'm sending him to the most nearest creation that Allah created other than our planets to stop them from reaching us, or else this whole world will be disappeared. I'm sending him there to stop them. He is by himself able to fight them all. One time in Medina, one day, Sayyidina Ali was walking, and adab, respect, discipline of Islam tells people when they are walking they have to respect the elderly person. He was walking, you know, in a hurry way, and there was a lady in front of him. He was reaching her, and she was carrying a basket. And walking, that lady, so adab, respect, he slowed down in order to make sure that she is walking in a nice way and he's walking. And then suddenly, he saw her tired. An old lady, very old lady. She came to her and said, "Oh my mother, can I help you to carry your basket, at least?" She said, "Why not? I would be glad that you can carry my responsibility. I will be glad that you can carry what I am carrying." He said, "For sure." She put the basket on the floor, on the ground, and Sayyidina Ali approached, hold the basket and say, "Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين." And carry that basket. You know, if you have a pitcher and you are carrying it and you know there is no water in it, you don't put too much weight to carry when you carry it. And if by mistake there was water, your hand goes down, because psychologically you think it's light, so you don't put an effort. But really it's not light, it's heavy, so you went with it down. So Sayyidina Ali, Prophet wants to teach him a lesson. Well, he thought it's a light basket, he is the liar. He took the basket by saying, "Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Allahumma salli wa sallam wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa sahbihi wa sallam." Carried the basket, he was falling, as if he was falling down, he controlled himself and carried that basket, was not able to reach his knees. And that poor lady, old lady, was carrying it up. And she looked at him and said, "Ya Ali," like that. No, radiallahu anhu wa karamallahu wa jannasi. "Ya Ali, I am the dunya. And this is the earth. I'm carrying it on my shoulder all the time. I'm tired from it. That's why now I am resting a little bit, because I'm dropping it down out of my shoulder, because I am in the time of the Prophet that Allah sending a sealed of messenger. He is the mercy for humanity. It's not necessary to carry it up to my shoulder, it's up to my knees. What you carry to your knees, this whole dunya is if put in a scale, and how much it's heavy for you, you were able to reach it to your knees." This to show how much Sayyidina Ali was strong. Allah gave him power. He said, "Oh my daughter, I'm sending him. In order that the influence or the attack of these people who are being created outside our creation, our planet, not to be able to come on earth and invade it. And that's why it is denied. These signs that Allah gave to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, different signs in the universe, shooting stars, eclipses, all these different galaxies and billions of stars, are all of them being given as a gift to Prophet. He is the Prophet for them, he is the seal of messenger for them. Don't think there is only our dunya and that's it. Don't think we are only have our 124,000 prophets and our prophet are the finished. There are other dunyas, there are other creations that Allah has sent a messenger, different from our messengers, but only not different is Sayyidina Muhammad, he is the messenger for them also. He is the messenger for every creation. Don't think that is too much, it's not too much for the greatness of Sayyidina Muhammad. When Allah gives greatness to someone, it's beyond limitation. Can you move forward, please? Oh Muslims, I will not be too long. I was going to speak on something else, but this is came because of that eclipse. And make sure that we must not be bankrupted one day. Because Prophet asked in a hadith that narrated by Bukhari and Muslim, he was asking his Sahaba, من المفلس؟ قالوا يا رسول الله المفلس من لا مال له. He asked, who is the bankrupt? And they said, Ya Rasulullah, the bankrupt, this is the one that has no money. Do we have money? Everyone has money. So you are not bankrupt. You are still living, eating and drinking. So he said, the Prophet said, no, that's not the issue. That's not this bankruptcy that I'm speaking about. I'm speaking about man al-muflis man la amal lah, who doesn't have a amal, who doesn't have good amal, that in the day of judgment he will go in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a poor, a bankrupt, nothing on him. Wa in sama wa in sallam. He said, if he is praying or he was praying and he was fasting, he has no amal. Hey, what happened? We are fasting and we are praying and we are saying, oh, we have good amal. Is not? The Prophet said, no. We don't. If we are backbiting others, Allah in the day of judgment will call us and call those whom we have been oppressing or backbited or make conspiracies against them or said bad things about them. Allah will take from your hasanat, give to them, from your rewards, good tidings, give to them, and take from your their sayyat, dump on them until you are finished. Honestly, I'm not going to be going too long on that, but let us say that the Prophet month Rabi'ul Awwal is coming. It's not so long. It's coming on very short next week and the week after it, like on the beginning of March. Let's remember Prophet extensively. Don't believe what they say and tell you. Don't exaggerate in a Prophet making salawat on Prophet. This is shirk. They are falling into going to be shy for them in the day of judgment. They are going to be shy in Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's presence. Do salawat as much as you like on Prophet. Invite people for Maulid of Prophet, for Prophet birthday, can be remembered during the whole year, and especially on 12th of Rabi'ul Awwal. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. May Allah bless us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المستغفرين فيا قوم المستغفرين أستغفر الله before I sin. Please, we have someone donated to the masjid some phones, cordless phone, and some shirts and some eyeglasses and some other things there for to be sold, and the money will go to the masjid. So we are not asking. Whatever we think that every phone is doesn't worth $100, but if some everyone will give $100, might be there are 10-15 phones there and some shirts like $20, whatever you can come from your heart, whatever you want to give. But make sure that you can buy them all in order that you can make some money for this month to pay up the loan that it is on it. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم عليك please ولسائر المستغفرين فيا قولا للمستغفرين استغفر الله. الحمد لله حمد الكاملين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. تعظيما لنبيه وتكريما بفخامة شأن صفيه فقال عز وجل من قائل مخبرا وآمرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الناهي أمته عن دار الجحيم مبخر العرب والعجم مولانا ومولى العالمين المحترمين سيدنا ابي القاسم محمد. يا ايها المشتاقون نور جماله والمحتاجون شفاعته صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى ال سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا ابراهيم وعلى ال سيدنا ابراهيم في العالمين انك حميد مجيد. وبارك اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى ال سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا ابراهيم وعلى ال سيدنا ابراهيم في العالمين انك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الاحياء منهم والاموات واغفر لنا ولاخواننا الذين سبقونا بالايمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين امنوا ربنا انك رؤوف رحيم يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم ارزقنا شفاعة حبيبك المصطفى عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام. اللهم اسقنا من كأسه وأولنا حوضه ووفقنا بمحبته. اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك منه سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. ونستعيذك من شر ما استعاذك منه سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم شرفنا برؤيته في الدنيا وفي الآخرة. اللهم شرفنا بصحبته في الدنيا وفي الآخرة. اللهم اجمعنا بروحانيته في الدنيا. اللهم اجمعنا به في الدنيا وفي الآخرة. إنك على كل شيء قدير وبالإجابة جدير. وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقيم الصلاة. يلا يا أخي أقيم الصلاة. يا أخي الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت